And now I have the honor to invite His Excellency, Mr. Kim Il-soo, Ambassador of Korea to the State of Israel, to say his words of greeting.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's my great pleasure to attend this annual Yonako meeting. Actually, I have been in this country a little bit less than 3 years, and attending this conference annually has become my habit. And because the conference takes place usually at the end of the year, I thought the last one, I mean in last December, was my last one to attend. But because of MICSI and coinciding organization of the meeting, it is taking place now in May. So I can have the honor of being invited to this important session for the first time. And I felt like I'm quite specially related to Yonako meeting. And I'd like to also have some compliment to Mr. Isaac Yona, who is quite rare among Israeli businessmen, who spent quite time working, living in Korea, and not limiting himself to that, but also developed interest in making career by connecting Korea and Israel. And meeting him, I just find him quite unique in his insights and understanding of Korea, quite original and penetrating. And sometimes I find the Koreanness from him with his conversation. And I'm very happy that the important job of connecting our two countries, and especially business sector, is now being done by somebody who understands both Korea and Israel so well. And ladies and gentlemen, it has already become a cliche that Korea and Israel has so much in common. And I'm always saying that two countries take pride in achieving developed economy and mature democracy on the tough security environment, I mean without any national resources to speak of, only relying on highly motivated and educated human capital. Maybe with the discovery of gas in the Mediterranean, one thing we have common is now going away, and I think Israel is more blessed and in terms of natural resources endowment. But I recently read an article written by a reporter of Israel Hayom, who visited Korea, and he mentioned that he found the Koreans, I mean, he wrote about the self-description by Koreans. He wrote that Koreans think they are unique and smarter and more aggressive and more hard-driving than any other nation. And he wrote also, that's exactly what, I mean, the Israelis are thinking of themselves. So I don't think, I mean, the common character we have doesn't end with the discovery of natural gas you did in the Mediterranean. And you know, it's also a very well-known fact that Korea's large and massive industrial and production base in the areas of electronics, automobiles, and I mean shipbuilding, petrochemical, or other areas, and they are a global network for business is something Koreans are proud of. But we also see great potential in win-win cooperation with Israel, which has great world-renowned ability for innovative capabilities in high technology. So we have done lots of work to combine these two potentials to create some win-win synergy effect. And this conference is also something that that's aimed at channeling and connecting these potentials we have. So all things said and done, I think actual cooperation is possible or started with contact between two people, and especially business sector. So I think the conference like Yonako carries quite an importance as a venue for doing that job, especially because this is the forum initiated by private sector. This year, we have quite a big delegation from Korea led by Ms. Dr. Park Ki-jae, who is, I would say, a Korean equivalent of OCS. So Mr. Abe Hassan is not here, but he's definitely the counterpart in Korea, who is responsible for R&D development and so on. And it's because, I mean, we have also MIXI taking place from Tuesday, and we have also many renowned representatives of the high-tech companies. And I also noticed from Israel side as well, we have quite a good number of leading businessmen. So I'm sure this year's Yonako meeting would be exceptionally successful. And just before ending my speech, I'd like to report what transpired in Korea through the Joint Economic Committee that took place 2 months ago. And one of the things we agreed was to organize Korea-Israel Innovation Day, which is something, I mean, Israel is doing only with Germany and Canada, but Korea becomes third country to organize Innovation Day. So it means it reflects the amount of interest two governments have in developing cooperation in the area of high technology. And it is not yet quite decided, I mean, when to start the long-awaited negotiation on a free trade agreement between our two countries. But as ambassador, I'm assuring you that we are doing our utmost to make it start as soon as possible. And I hope with the conclusion of this free trade agreement with Israel, you know, our trade, investment, and cooperation technology will get a great boost in the future. So thank you much again for attending this conference, and thank you for your kind invitation, and welcome to all the delegation from Korea. And I wish you most productive day today and tomorrow. Please find, please know each other better, and also find your good partner in future business transaction. Thank you very much.